Hi everyone, it's Colette here with Out Late But Great, your hostess on the channel for Tuesdays. I wanted to apologize to you guys. I was unable to make a video last week on Tuesday. I was doing a makeup job and I didn't get done till really late. So when I got home, I didn't have time to make a video. And then on the weekend, I totally intended on making one, but I ended up just totally forgetting to do it. So I apologize for that. And so today I meant to really do the video super early and get it out to you because my boyfriend ended up having some oral surgery. So I took the day off. So I was able to get on here and make a video before I go to bed like I normally do. But I hope you guys are doing well. And, yeah, I was able to pick the topic for this week, and my topic is, given our current volatile culture, what gives you hope? Is there anything that helps you balance the chaos in the media? Bonus, what book are you currently reading? So, ice cream tea. So, I chose this topic because I feel in the past couple months, it's just been really chaotic in social media and in the news. Like every time I would go on Facebook, there's just tons of posts about all sorts of just craziness, conspiracy theories, blogs that really just are very negative based. A lot of it has to do with the elections and other like just heartbreaking stuff that you see in the news. And after a while, it can just be overwhelming and it kind of makes you feel like, gosh, we're just going to hell in a handbasket. Like life is just terrible. Things are just bad. And it kind of, for me, it's a little bit too much. Like I've been finding myself just feeling slightly depressed or whatever. And I didn't really know what it was stemming from. So I decided to go ahead and delete Facebook off my phone. So now when I go on Facebook, I check it maybe once a day or even less than that. So I'm not really in the loop with everything that's going on. And that actually has been a great balance for me because I can check in, but I'm not on there constantly scrolling through there, like seeing what everything's going on. And it's been kind of a relief because I don't feel the need to check it because it's not there. And, I don't end up reading these articles that really have no critical thinking. It's just a negative conspiracy theory strung out there. And I'm like, why am I wasting my time reading all this and like partaking in it? And what I found is since I've kind of pulled away from a lot of social media stuff and even reading the news, I find that I'm being more creative. I'm writing more. I'm playing my guitar. I'm thinking about stuff that I want to do in more of a creative sense. And that really makes me feel more invigorated, I guess you can say. And I've made a conscious decision to just surround myself with people that motivate me and things that kind of remind me to go and be creative. Like Michelle here on Outlate But Great, she posts a picture every day. And for me, that gets me excited. She's always posting cool stuff that makes me want to like, okay, it reminds me to go for a hike. It reminds me I need to practice my guitar, stuff like that. Like I love following people like her because it just, it reminds me of what gives me hope, and that's being creative and being around art. And I found myself feeling a lot more balanced, and I end up calling my friends more because I don't really know what's going on online. So I feel the need to talk more on the phone, which I love because everyone that I love lives so far away. So it's so nice to be able to like reconnect on the voice and like, I don't know. And I get really excited because I want to go visit people before I have to go have surgery again. So I'm trying to like plan that out and stuff like that. Like I find is really balancing out all the chaos that I'm seeing going around in the world, just in my own little world. And that gives me hope. And I guess that would be my suggestion to any of our viewers. If you're kind of feeling overwhelmed, I just really recommend unplugging, like not completely cut yourself off. Like I still check in with the election and current events just so I kind of know what's going on in the world. And, but I just don't read too much into it anymore, because it can really suck you in. And I don't know, like it's just too much. Then you get burnt out and it's just, you know. So yeah, that's what I've been doing. And what I'm currently reading, I'm actually reading a couple of books right now. I'm reading, it's called Soiled Doves. It's by Anne Seagraves. It's a book about prostitution during the Wild West. And another book I'm reading, I can't remember the name of it. It's another book about women in the Wild West, and I think it's prostitution based. I don't know why I'm reading about prostitution in the Wild West, but I've been really obsessed with women of the Wild West. And I think it's because growing up, my dad had me watch a lot of Wild West, like documentaries, movies, everything you could think of growing up, and everything was very male dominated. And I remember I went to like a local history museum, and I was completely sucked into this book display of all these books about women of the Wild West. And I really sat back and thought about, wow, like how would it have been to be a woman, like leaving the East Coast, traveling on a wagon, and with all these Victorian clothes, like corsets, layers of clothes, in the heat, coming into an unforeign land with all sorts of crazy obstacles. And it's so interesting that it's not really written about as much in detail as men are, and how basically when a woman went with her husband over the Wild West, you know, they were very submissive, but when by the end, when they got to the location, they were basically stronger than their husband. They had to endure more than their husband. And now their husbands were shocked because now their woman was no longer submissive. Like the man was submissive because the woman now ran the show. So, and it's been really cool to learn about these women in history and how some women lived as men, which I found really interesting, and why they decided to do that. And just some of the tragic stories, and how some actually the women that were prostitutes, how they were successful businesswomen, and actually some of them didn't have the best lives. I didn't know Calamity Jane was actually a prostitute. That was interesting because I remember watching that musical. So I'm just learning a lot, and that's currently what I'm reading, and I'm just obsessed with it. And I have like a stack more of books I found about women of the Wild West and like homesteaders. These women homesteaders in Wyoming and Montana. I don't know why I'm obsessed with reading all this, but that's literally where I'm at in my life right now. So, anyway, that's my video for this week. I hope you guys take care, and I will talk to you soon. Oh, and if you want to know what lip I'm wearing, I just got this. It's a vegan lipstick by Caked, and it's called Sweet Tooth. And it literally smells like coconut cream. It's so yummy, and it's kiss proof. Look at that. Okay, bye.